Hi guys, Kirk from Dick's Taxidermy. So today I'm going to show you an antelope that I'm having to remount. A hunter in our area went and had it mounted at a taxidermy shop somewhere here locally, and was very unhappy with what he got back. So I wanted to show you where the taxidermist made the mistake. And you know, it's pretty obvious to all of us, but I think the taxidermist wasn't paying attention. So if we look right here, we can see where the outside of the mannequin is on both sides. Well, the outside of the antelope eye is way in here. We're talking about this form is an inch wider on this side and a half inch wider on this side. So he didn't even get it centered in the center of the mannequin. And then the mannequin's wider than what the skull is to start with. So this is why I tell you it's so, so important to have the whole skull, take the measurements, alter the mannequin to make it fit. However, if you bring me the whole skull and I don't measure it and I don't alter the mannequin, I guess it doesn't do any good anyway. So you can just see here what sloppy taxidermy work does. Guy paid kind of a cheap price for a mount, and he got a really bad mount, and now he's upset. You can see on this side where he tried to line the eye orbital up with the form, and it's set back about an inch back on this side. He's an inch back with the eye orbital. Over on this side, looks like he's lined up pretty close, still isn't correct. So now we know the skull's even turned at an angle. So I'm gonna throw in some snapshots and maybe a little bit more video as we try to fix this antelope. And maybe it will give you guys some idea of what we need to do or how we mount some of these animals. Okay, so here I wanted to show you where they cut the lip line in. Look at that gap in there. That gap is supposed to be about an eighth of an inch, and it's probably a half inch wide. There's no way you're gonna tuck that lip in there nice and tight and get that to stay in there. There should be just a very slight little gap in there, and you should glue the skin lip down inside there. What I'll do is when I cut the lip from the new foam, I will take some photos of that so I can show you that.